Welcome back to Fabric Tech Talk Fridays. I'm Patrick, and I'm here with my fantastic co-host, Swetha, for another deep dive into Microsoft Fabric. Today, we're talking about a game-changing innovation in data storage and management, OneLake in Microsoft Fabric. OneLake is revolutionizing the way organizations store, share, and analyze data by eliminating those dreaded data silos and enabling a seamless, unified data experience.
Absolutely, Patrick. And who better to walk us through it than our special guest, Josh, partner director at Microsoft, leading the OneLake product innovations. Josh, welcome to Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
Thanks for having me. I'm super excited to be here.
Let's start with the big picture. Why was OneLake created and what problems does it solve?
Well, data lakes in general were meant to solve data silos and break down all your data and bring it together in one place. It'll be analyzed and blended together. But data lakes have such challenges. You end up with these multiple siloed different data lakes where you have to then build solutions on top to break down the silos yourself.
All right. I know you have prepared a demo for us. Let's get right into it. Enough of all this talking, Josh. Let's get to the laptop.
Let's do it.
Hey, I love it.
So here I am in a Fabric workspace. And creating workspaces in Fabric is very, very simple, very straightforward. You can just do it a couple clicks. I'm going to go into one I already have. And in here, you see that I have one data item. A data item is like a lake house, a warehouse. Here, it happens to be a data warehouse. When I go into a data warehouse, what you're going to see is what you should see in any data warehouse experience you go into. It feels like basically SSMS in the web. I have a bunch of schemas in here, really one schema. And if I go into that schema, I have one table. And that table has a little bit of data. Now, even though this looks and feels like SQL, all of the data is actually stored inside OneLake. And we can see it. And because OneLake is the OneDrive for data, we can see it like OneDrive, right in Windows. I see the same list of workspaces. I see our data item. We see our table, our schema, just the one table with data in it. Now, to create another table, I just do this like SQL. I have a SQL statement here. It creates the table, inserts a row, selects from that row, just like I'm using any SQL experience. Flipping back, though, now you see the new table created in OneLake. And you see the Delta log, and you see the data itself stored in a Parquet file. So even if you don't know anything about open source file formats, open data lakes, if you know how to work with SQL, you know how to work with any Fabric workload for that matter, you can write data to OneLake, store data in OneLake in these open file formats without anything new.
Wow. Josh, that was incredible. I love how OneLake connects data seamlessly without actually moving the data, right? That's a game changer for organizations dealing with complex data architectures. But from your experience working with all these different customers that's using OneLake, what's the biggest benefits they're seeing after they adopt OneLake?
Mm-hmm. Well, let's think about, why do you put your data in the lake in the first place? Why does it matter? Yeah, it looks and feels like SQL, but we store it in the lake. So what? Well, let's say you're another part of the organization.
Yep.
You're on the finance team. I'm in the sales team.
Sure.
And you need to use this data. Well, you could set up a pipeline, you could build your own lakehouse, you could copy it out, you could keep it up to date, or you could do something a little simpler. So let's actually flip over to your workspace here. You're in a completely different business domain, and your workspace is empty at the moment, but you're gonna now go create a lakehouse. Now, lakehouses are really our most lake-like item that we have. And what I mean by that is it does both structured data, unstructured data. You can do what you can do in ADLS containers, mm-hmm. You can do here in a lakehouse. But it also supports tables as well. And instead of ETLing our data, out of that warehouse, I'm going to create a new shortcut. And this brings up the OneLake catalog. Mm. This is where all our data in OneLake is discoverable and usable. And we can even filter this down by domains. So I can see the official data now. It shows me all the data I have access to, but I'm going to filter it down to the sales domain.
Okay.
And in the sales domain, we now see all the data I have access to, but we also see the official data from the sales domain. What they've officially endorsed. So not just the data swamped, not the stuff that someone put in there, but the actual official data. And I can click on that warehouse we were using earlier. We see the same two tables in there. We see that sales table, and we just create the shortcut. And in seconds, that data is going to appear here as if we had physically copied it, but no data movements actually happen.
Okay, so now this is interesting because this data was in Fabric or in the Microsoft Cloud. What if I want to access data outside of Fabric or outside of the Microsoft Cloud?
Well, I can shortcut that too. Let's say our customer data is actually being managed by Snowflake and being stored in Amazon S3. I can shortcut to Amazon S3.
Fancy.
So we'll create a shortcut to that as well. Any open file system, any open storage format. So in this case, Snowflake actually uses Iceberg. So I'll put in my S3 connection information. And when we actually connect, we'll see that it is an Iceberg. Now, Fabric uses what we call Delta Lake. Yep. Different formats. Data actually happens to be saved all in Parquet. So what we can do here is when we actually shortcut in, here you see that customer dimension. You see it's an Iceberg format. There's no Delta log like we saw in the last table. Mm-hmm. Doesn't matter here, though. I'll create the shortcut. And again, within seconds, it's going to appear here like it's physically been copied over. Again, no data movements occurred. We didn't copy any data. They were in different file formats, but all we did was translate over the iceberg metadata to Delta Lake virtually. And you'll see that in a second. Again, the data will appear here as if we copied it, but no data movements actually occurred. So if we go look at the files, we'll see here is you have the Delta log. That's been virtually created based off the Iceberg metadata. And now that we have a Delta log here, we can use this with any Fabric engine. So if I go into SQL, endpoint here, not only can I query this data, but we have the data that we natively have in OneLake. We have the data that we actually have coming from S3 that's actually coming from Snowflake. Not only can we use them together, we can join them together. And I still get one row of data, but in this case, instead of a GUID for the customer name, now I have the actual customer name and their total sales for that period.
Now, let me ask you a question. So we know how data engineers are, and we know how our report consumers and our data consumers are. We need more data. So if changes happen to, let's say, in Snowflake or in the S3 compliant source, do I need to go do something, or does that data automatically appear?
Yeah, so you're working off the original copy of the data. There is no copy here. So let's see what actually happens. Let's flip back to that data warehouse, and let's finally add a second row of data.
Okay.
So I'll just insert it as normal. You don't even have to know this is happening, right? I'm updating my data. I'm responsible for updating my data. I'm responsible for keeping it in sync. I'm responsible for keeping it secure. You are just consuming it. Mm-hmm. So I insert this row.
Yeah.
Let's flip back to you for a minute and see what happens. We're going to run your query again. You get that second sale.
Ah, that's beautiful.
Mm-hmm. You're working off the same copy of data as me. And hopefully tomorrow we'll have a third sale and a fourth sale. And you know, when business gets going, we'll fill the whole screen here eventually.
Okay. So I'm not lazy, Josh. I'm really efficient. So let's just conserve that data.
That was amazing, Josh. But for organizations trying to get started with OneLake, what is your advice?
Just try it. I mean, it's truly revolutionary in the way you'll work. And the way you'll build out data lakes now and share data across your organization. And you can get started today for free with an F64 trial. All available, just starting out for free.
That's fantastic, Josh. Thank you so much for walking us through OneLake's power and potential. That's it for today. Thanks again to Josh for joining us. See you all next Friday. Thank you everyone for watching. If you found this video valuable, don't forget to hit that like button.
If this is your first time visiting the Microsoft Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to smash that subscribe button.
Drop a comment below on what you would like to see on the future episodes of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
That's it for today. See you all next Friday for another deep dive in the Microsoft Fabric.